Rise from your grave.
Alright, I'm a composer. Learning about other composers is really cool. Reading about their lives and seeing how they got started is a good way to look back on my own journey and seeing how they looked at things and, like, getting a different perspective and all. Hopefully, you can have fun learning about them like I have, but don't expect me to go into full music theory mode because I'm instinct. I'm Hector, and other people are Elwood. But regardless, I hope you guys like this. You know what game series has good music? Persona. Why? Because Shoji Meguro is a goddamn wild card when it comes to compositions. One day, he could feel full-on electric metal. Another day, he could feel hip-hop jazz fusion. Or sometimes, he just does stuff that kicks ass. Now, when I was reading up about this guy, I was honestly quite interested in how he does his music, since most of the guitar work in his tracks are done by him. Yet growing up, he wanted to get into Formula One racing and majored in engineering. I think it's pretty neat, but let's start at the beginning. Shoji Meguro was born on June 4th, 1971 in Tokyo. He was born around a lot of tech constantly, so he was naturally interested in electrical musical instruments. Most notably, a small electric organ he was encouraged by his mom because she was like, yeah, that's pretty dope. He then got some lessons and took a liking to classical composers like Beethoven and Tchaikovsky. He also thought J-pop was shit, so yeah, man of culture. He started to gain more musicianship by playing his own versions of TV and films that he watched, which I will honestly say on personal experience, Mortal Kombat, thank you. Later on in high school, Shoji joined a brass band and picked up the trombone. He got his own computer in which he played a bunch of games and learned some programming as well. He didn't own any consoles, so he was basically a PC Master Race boy. Shoji's musical influences were quite varied during his high school arc, as he decided to listen to more mainstream stuff, eventually warming up to J-pop, and then more leaning toward jazz fusion liking artists such like Herb Alpert, Cassiope, and T-Square. And Cassiope and T-Square! Guys, just look up, this is completely unrelated, but you gotta listen to Fight Man, dude. It is the hypest shit. Using their sounds to create his own works, Shoji also created his own band playing the synthesizer and guitar, which is neat as hell. What I like about Shoji is that he always has this amazing ability to masterfully convey mood through his pieces. His use of instrumentation and musicianship is seen quite well, like, for example, Persona 5's use of light and dark in its musical tone. I honestly can't explain this better than how 8-Bit Music Theory does on his explanation, but in short, he inverses the regular dark mood in music using modes and makes it more heroic, basically giving you like an inverse of how a heroic theme would feel if you were playing the villain. Also, this dude, he fucking plays a live set on stage with Jun Senmu, and it's Crush 40, Sonic the Hedgehog, and they do a duet of Sonic and Persona songs, and it's like the hypest shit, freaking Morgana's dancing with Sonic, I don't even know, it's great, I will send the link on the bottom, but you guys gotta watch it. And if you're looking even deeper, if you ever played like Shin Megami Tensei 3 Nocturne, featuring Dante from the Devil May Cry series, he takes the idea of what a world after the end sounds like, and it hits like a goddamn. His use of sound design really shines through so hard playing this game, like, and especially when you hear. If you hear his work once, you can see why in a good portion of Atlus games. If you want to emulate him, I suggest learning heavy guitar licks, listening to some 80s J-pop, and abusing text-to-speech noises, and acquiring a taste for jazz fusion. Shoji Meguro makes some of the best music in games due to his ability to adapt and his knowledge of tech. If anything, I do hope you check out the music of the games he's worked on. I'll leave some links on the bottom if you're interested. And if you like me being autistic and talking about this stuff, great. And if you didn't, that's cool too. Okay, I love you, bye!